Okay. So, our objectives for today's session are the following. Okay. To have a better understanding of what a speech contest is, the rule book, okay? 2020-2021, because every year there are revisions happening. Just like last year, there was no such thing as online. This year, we have online contests. And also for us to be knowledgeable on how to do certain roles such as specifically for the counter and timer. Because this time, doing online contests, we find it, based on our personal observations, attending various club contests this term, it's quite tedious to monitor how the functionaries such as the counter and timer do their role. So we have to ensure, because these two specific roles are critical in a contest, whatever level it be, club, area, division, especially the district, and for our judges to know how to judge speech contests. All right? Can I see a thumbs up from your screens if we all agree to have this, to meet the certain objectives at the end of this session? Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. And of course, okay. So just before I start, some friendly reminders, okay? Let's have an open mind and share our best practices, okay? Let's participate actively. I hope I will not bore you. And of course, the most important thing, in doing anything, let's have fun, okay? So let's start. Starting with the latest update on the speech contest rules. This is the latest speech contest rule book, 2020-2021. And this is free. You don't have to pay for anything, okay? Just browse the Toastmasters website. The source, you can search it in the Toastmasters International website and look for speech contest rule book. You will find there 2020-2021 with Aaron Beverly as its cover. So he was the winner from 2019, okay? So what's up? What were the things that changed? Okay, going to the eligibility of the contestants, it is said that only members who joined Toastmasters prior to the rollout of pathways in their region can apply speeches from competent communication manual to speech contest eligibility. So meaning, contestants are eligible to join for the members who are enrolled on pathways. And for those members who joined prior the rollout of pathways, meeting the competent communication norm, okay? So that means for the competent communication norm, at least 6 speech projects prior, and for the pathways, at least level 2, okay? At least level 2. So in addition to that, if a charter member of a club was chartered less than 1 year, okay, the club contest is permitted, okay, year before the club contest is permitted to compete without having completed this requirement. The club must be officially chartered prior the area contest. Okay, so meaning, if there's a club that was formed this term, they're allowed to compete in the international speech contest. Okay, if they haven't met the 1 year term, okay, as long as they were chartered prior the area contest. Okay, they are allowed, they're permitted to join the international speech contest. So it's also critical for the contest organizers to check on the charter date of the club, and especially the eligibility of the contestants. Okay. So, just to explain this further, okay, only members who join Toastmasters prior the rollout of Pathways in the region can apply speeches. Yeah, that's what I said. I want to reiterate that again. And from the competent communication manual to speech contest eligibility. Okay, you can see that in the contest rulebook. So we're highlighting this. Okay, we want to stress this part because just to share, we had disqualification last year that reached to the district level. Reached to the district level. And it so happened that the contestant or the club didn't know that the contestant must meet at least level 2. So imagine the frustration from the contestant. The club doesn't know, the contestant doesn't know, and when she made it to the district level, she was disqualified. The next winner or the second place has to take on the post. Okay? So it's important, it's very important to know what were the new rules, especially the eligibility. Of course, part of which you have to be a paid member. Make sure you pay your dues on time, okay? All right. Now, moving to the judges, aside from being a paid member, okay, all the functionaries, the chief judge, voting judge, the tie-breaking judge, contest master, okay, you must all be paid member for at least minimum of 6 months, okay, and have completed the minimum of 6 speeches if you've been part of the competent communication, or the legacy program that was prior July 24, 2017 rollout, okay, or earn the certificates level 2 that was after July 24, 2017, pathways, level 2 from the pathways experience, okay. So it's the same thing. Are we good? Still with me, guys? Thumbs up, please. Thumbs up. Or can I see an exclamation point in the chat box so that you can practice, have an exercise for your fingers, small exercise for your fingers, please. Okay. Good, good. Thank you, Dennis. Thank you, Leah. Okay. Moving on to the speech subject and preparation. Okay. Part of the updates is such that a contestant must not make reference to the previous, to the prior contestants, previous contestants, or another contestant from the platform at the same contest in which they are competing. Okay. There was, before this was implemented, I witnessed this, I think that was way back when I was the club president. We were amazed with the contestant because she was able to make reference to the previous contestants, and it was a humorous speech contest. She was the, I think, second to the last contestant, and her speech was all about the other contestants' speeches. She was able to creatively, you know, weave the story, organize the speech, and she won. Well, of course, there were some protests, some concerns, and the reason is that why is this implemented now? Okay, because it's unfair for the previous, for the other contestants, because the contestant is building on the success of other contestants, right? And to be fair, in terms of originality, you come up with your own topic. So this time, it is not allowed. Contestants are not allowed to capitalize on the contestants or make reference to the previous, to other contestants' speeches. So gone are the days that, okay, thank you so much for, I would like to commend speech contestant number 2 because I can relate to that experience. So no more. Or refer to the quote that he or she has said or share a story similar to that. No na yun. Okay? Clear? Okay. Now, going to protests and disqualifications. Ayan. Okay. We also have to look into this because as mentioned earlier, we had some hostilities. Akala nyo lang hindi competitive ang District 75. District 75 was so competitive that speech contests are very controversial. So protests and disqualifications, really, we have to put reference and special emphasis on this. Okay. So a protest are limited to the eligibility, in terms of eligibility and originality, as well as the reference to another contestant's speech. Okay. And this will only be lodged to who? Lodged by the judges or the contestants. If you are an online attendee and you are not a contestant or a judge, you cannot make a protest. Okay. Any protest must be lodged to the chief judge or contest chair prior the announcement of the winners. Okay. So if you're not the judge or the contestant and you think that, okay, I think there was certain disqualification because he or she is not paid, then you have to notify perhaps your contestant or one of the contestants so that it will be raised to the chief judge. Okay, it's only the judges and the contestants who can lodge the protest or disqualification to the chief judge or the contest chair. Okay, when this happens, okay, the chief judge, contest chair, voting judges, and contestants must not consider any other protest from the audiences. And before a contestant can be disqualified on the basis of what? Originality, eligibility, and referencing of another contestant's speech. The contestant must be, of course, be given a chance to explain to the judges. Okay? And the judges must concur and make a decision if they will be disqualified or not. That is the reason why the judges, when you are tapped as one of the judges, you cannot leave the contest the moment until the contest is finished or until the winners were announced, because there might be protests that will be raised before the announcement of the winner. So as judges, you are part of the committee of the chief judge to decide and to check on the references, is it valid, is it not? See, that's also part of your role, okay? And it's the contest chair who can disqualify the contestant based on eligibility. So, we're done with the protests and disqualifications. Thumbs up, everyone, to my audience, if you're still alive. Would like to thank the 62 participants, also the technical team, for joining this online session on a Saturday morning. I know some of you would want to have longer sleeping hours, yet you made it a point to be with us. So thank you once again. All right, so we move on to the next topic. Protest and disqualifications, okay? Okay. Part of the International Speech Contest rules, okay? For those who are aspiring to be an international speech contestant, okay? It is mentioned here that every participant in World Championship of Public Speaking must present an entirely new and different speech than the one presented during the year semifinal speech or any previous year semifinal and final round speech contest. That means that when you decide to join, I got this from Neb Perez, a good friend of ours, that you have to at least prepare two speeches. Two speeches. That is for international speech contest. Why? Because if you made it to the area, division, and district, syempre, when you make it to the district level, you have all the chances, right? It all depends on how you want it, how you really wanted to win. Okay, prepare at least two speeches if you aspire to join an international speech contest. Okay, because you cannot make use of your previews of the speech, the winning piece you had in the district level. The moment you make it to the finals, you have to make an entirely new. Okay, and if you make it to the regional quarterfinals, the semis, and then the finals, okay, the more you will have less time, no? So preparation, preparation is really a key. Be prepared for it. Come in prepared always, right? Okay. And, okay. Sorry. Okay, there you go. So moving on. There you go. So the contests in our district, okay, in District 75 are the following. We have the table topics, we have the humorous speech, evaluation, and international speech contest. It's not called international prepared speech contest because it's already a prepared speech. It's international speech contest, okay? We have to make sure that everyone is using the same language, and yeah, you're using the proper names of the contests. Okay, all district finals are to be held at the district conference. So since we are not yet allowed to do social gathering, we will do the district conference and the competitions online. Okay. Questions so far? If you have questions, okay, please type it in the box, chat box, and our technical team will take note of it. We'll compile it and try to answer it at the end of the session. Okay, so thumbs up, everyone. Thumbs up. Get your glass of coffee. I'm having my energy drink now. You can't see it here. Okay, I have to remove my virtual background. Take a pause. Okay. Take a pause. Okay, there you go. Okay. I'm having my energy drink. And if you have your tea, anything that will perk you up, better. Okay, because this time we will proceed with timers and talliers. Okay. The functionaries in any speech contest are as follows. So the marshals, these are the technical personnel or the Zoom masters. Okay, we have the timekeepers, we have the talliers, voting judges, tie-breaking judge, chief judge, contest master, contest chair, contestants, and test speaker. We will be focusing on what? The timer and the tallier only. Okay. Trivia. Okay, for those who know the answer, okay, please type in the box. No need to unmute yourself. Type in the box. Okay. I have three trivia questions. First, okay, how many timers do we have in a speech contest? How many timers do we have in a speech contest? Okay. Good. I'm seeing the answers. Melinda, 2. Okay. We have one for an answer. There was an answer of three. Okay. We only need two timers. Okay. I'm not a two timer, but we need two timers in a speech contest. Okay. So, second, thank you for those who answered. Do give yourselves a round of applause. Okay, applause. Give the applause icon. Or thank you for your participation. Second, trivia question. How many ballot counters should be there in a district speech contest? Okay, type your answers in the chat box. Okay. Ballot counters, come on. I can see answers of two. Three. Mm-hmm. Okay, I guess this is good enough. The correct answer is three. This time, we need three ballot counters, not two, three. And the last question. Who announces the results of the speech contest? Type in your answer. Okay, I see Goldie, contest chair, TME, chief judge, president, chief judge, chair. Mm-hmm. See, we have a variety of answers, no? And to address this concern and avoid confusion, the correct answer is the speech contest chair. It's the speech contest chair. Well, if the club president is the speech contest chair of the club contest, then the club president, as the speech contest chair, announces the winners of the competition. If it is the vice president for education, who is the speech contest chair of the club contest, then he or she is the one to announce the speech contest. Crystal? Claro? Here? Thank you, Crystal. Very good. Okay, let's start with the timer's role. You get to see this familiar device, no? The yellow and the red timing device, okay? This is essential, of course, so that the speakers will be notified if they've met the allowable time, they were on time, or about to go over time, or they met the allocated time. Okay, just to go through this, okay, let us see. For international and humorous speech contest, because these are prepared speeches, the time is 5 to 7 minutes. Okay, 5 in green, 6 minutes with yellow, and 7 in red. Evaluation, 2 to 3 minutes. 2 minutes green, 2 to 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 30 seconds yellow, and 3 minutes on red. And for, okay, let's skip that, okay. And for the table topics, 1 minute green, 1 minute, 30 seconds yellow, and 2 minutes for red. Same as how we do it in the club contest, or same as how we do it, practice it in our club program. 5 to 7 minutes for prepared speeches, 2 to 3 minutes for evaluation, table topics, 1 to 2 minutes. Now, the question is, when will they be disqualified? How is this qualification in terms of time happens? for the prepared speeches, international and humorous, if the time is less than 4 minutes and 30 seconds and more than 7 minutes and 30 seconds, even just for 1 second, 7 minutes 31 second, the contestant is definitely disqualified. Okay. For evaluation, going to evaluation, if the evaluation is less than 1 minute and 30 seconds or more than 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Okay. While for the table topics, minimum is should be at least 1 minute. You cannot be less than a minute. Okay? And if you are more than 2 minutes and 30 seconds. All right? I hope this is clear when it comes to the timing. That's why briefing for the timers is also essential. We have to repeat and repeat what are the timing, allocation, and the disqualifications. Okay, and these are the, since we're doing the contest online, you can easily download this Toastmasters Zoom background for your logo, the one with the Toastmasters logo, the other one with the Toastmasters brand name. So it's up to you. It has to be clear from the contestants that you are the timer, you are pinned, of course, the contestants has the responsibility. But as a timer, the moment you're assigned as the timer, you need this Zoom backgrounds and as backup, always have a backup plan. If your computer is not ready for such Zoom backgrounds, then you have flashcards that is shown on your camera as clearly as possible. As timers, it's not necessary that your face is known, face is shown on the screen. What's essential is the timing. The timing cues for the contestants to know if they were already meeting the green light or the minimum time or red or about to go over time, right? So make sure that these are clearly shown on screen. Tsaka na, you will be acknowledged naman later on after the contest, okay? The functionaries, the rule takers, but not the judges, okay? So the timing record, okay, we have a time record sheet. This is also downloadable at the Toastmasters website. So simply write the name of the contestants based on the order of contestants and write their specific time. Okay, why do we have two timers? Because one of the timers will be the one flashed on screen. The other timer will be the one to take note of the time, start the timing cue. Okay, and both of them will do the timing, but one of them is flashed on screen. The other will do the recording of the time on the timer sheet. And then they just have to compare notes if they have the same time or if the contestant is really overtime or not and make a concurrence on that recorded on the timer sheet. Okay? So, as mentioned, write the speaking order and the timer's record sheet is submitted to the chief judge. No other functionaries but to the chief judge. And the time should be kept confidential as well. Okay? Moving on. Ballot counters. Okay. Ballot counters is we are asked to have three ballot counters. So in the counting room, ballot counters will tabulate the results of the contest using counters tally sheet. Before we have a room, now we have the online meeting. We make use of what? The messenger group, Viber, breakout rooms possible. Just make sure there's no leakage, okay? what's working with us, we make use of Messenger. So we have to see that the ballot counters have their messengers, and we can communicate through Messenger so that we can monitor the tabulation of the results clearly. So each contestant receives a point wherein they are being ranked as first, second, or first, second, or third. And then, di ba, first place will have 3 points, second, 2 points, and 1 point for the third place rank. Okay. So all points will be entered at the ballot, ballot sheet. Okay, tabulated and then verified. Okay. And if in case there is an error in the announcement of the winners, the ballot counters can call out the contest chair who announced it. And there's already the results form. It's clear there, the first place, second place, and third place. Okay, they also fix the order of announcement of the winners, so there will be no more confusion. Okay. There you go. These are the things that I mentioned earlier. Mm-hmm. The sheet, we have the tally sheet, also downloadable at the Toastmasters website. Mm-hmm. So you have to write the name on top. Okay, write the name on top and then get the total scores at the end. So in this case, in our example, contestant 1 is 1, 2 is 2, Dimitri is 3rd contestant, 4th contestant is Portia, and Deluna is the 5th contestant. Okay, among the contestants, the first place rank is Dimitri, who accumulated 11 points. 2nd is 1 with 10 points. 3rd is Portia, and so on and so forth. So, there you go. First place winner is Dimitri. 1 goes 2nd, and 3rd is with Portia. Okay. If in case there is a tie, patay! May tie! If there is a tie, our second speaker will explain this clearly. So hang on to that, okay? The tie-breaking judge is the only one who can break the tie. That's why you're the tie-breaking judge. And the tie-breaking judge is only known to the chief judge. Okay, the chief judge. Same with the timer's report. Okay, now, I think we're still on time, hopefully. If you want to know more, we have the speech contest resources flashed on screen. Just check out the Toastmasters website, www.toastmasters.org, Leadership Central Speech Contest. Everything is there, even the online how to organize speech contest. All you have to do is click it, read it, absorb it, apply it. All right, so thank you so much for having me as your first speaker. I do hope I was able to share this with you. Okay, share the knowledge on how to conduct or organize speech contests, especially on the functionalities, and some clarifications from the updates from the rule book 2020-2021. Okay, if you have some questions, okay, chat box, and then we will respond through it if we have enough time before we proceed with the next speaker. All right, back to you, Dennis.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. That was IPDD Miss Anne. Thank you very much. Truly, it was really a presentation full of knowledge, of course, with sprinkles of actual experiences and benchmarking practices from the different divisions or districts of Toastmasters. So I really do believe that we have had our heads full of knowledge. But of course, the challenge there is really to apply all of the things that we learned. So we'll have a few minutes to address some of the questions that you may have. So if you can just send us a message in the chat box, type your question in the chat box, or quickly unmute your microphone and then just ask the question so that we will properly address them. So just a moment of time of a pause so that we can let our audience throw in their questions. So this is your time, guys. Anyone? Anyone? So while I'm waiting for anybody to unmute their micro question. Okay, here's a question. So sending again the question, let me just read it from Victor Esguera. For announcement of winners, I know the rules say that the chair will make the announcement, but I think we should have the option to ask the chief judge to make the announcement. Is this okay?
No, it's not okay. It's said that it's the contest chair who will make the announcement. Okay, it's written. It's written in the rule book. This is not implemented by District 75. It's implemented by who? Toastmasters International. And we have to comply as part of the organization. Okay?
Okay. There. So I hope that is really that's a clear-cut answer if you ask me, because it really comes from, you know, or that's, you know, an entity that's higher, that's above us. So again, probably another question here: if a contestant refers to any previous contestant, no matter how little the reference, maybe just a small mention, is it automatic disqualification?
If that will be pointed out, okay, that will be pointed out by one of the judges, and they will have a concurrence that the contestant made a reference and so on, they will check on the recording. As written on the rule book, no reference or whatsoever, no matter how small it is. So as contestants, do not make reference to other contestants so that your stand as a winner will not be compromised. Right? So just follow the rules. Simply follow the rules.
I think that's really the statement that makes the best sense. Now, avoid doing the things that will really draw you closer to a disqualification. So yeah, those are not only clear instructions, but wise words coming from Miss Anne. So I'd like to check if there are still any questions. Let me do a soft countdown so that we can proceed. Okay, let me see, probably a comment. We used to have that practice that it's the chief judge. Okay, so just going back to the earlier question, it's the chief judge who announces the results, but then it's good that it's emphasized by our speaker this morning. So yeah, I think what's good there is we have been updated. And I guess that's one of the clear purposes of Miss Anne during her presentation, that we need to be updated with the changes, no matter how minor they are. They do have an impact on how we conduct these contests and how the judges should be able to, you know, make good in their role. So yeah, good stuff, everyone. So let me do a soft countdown. Just a few comments. When will be the event and time? Thanks, probably that can just be answered as a private message. Can the chief judge and contest chair and contest master be one person?
Whew, okay. There were some incidents. Okay, in the past, there were some incidents that they had won, especially for club contest, because they lacked on members who can do the functions well. And this is one of the reasons why we are conducting such session, the judges training and organizing speech contests, so that a lot of our members will know how to do it. You know how difficult it is to multitask, right? In a club meeting, in a program, if you are the Toastmaster of the day, you are the speaker, and then you happen to be one of the technical evaluators, you are doing multiple roles. Imagine what more in a speech contest if you're doing all those three roles. Diba? Magkaloka, mabuang ka man dali. No? Bangka. So, we have to divide the responsibility. And if you have more members who are involved in the speech contest, I'm sure you are not only making more leaders from your club or from the district, you are also helping them on how to share the knowledge and apply what they've learned from those masters.
That's great. That's a great short but simple answer. That's really clear. And really, we just need to tap in our one of our best resource, which is really to continue to mentor and coach our members so that they will be able to step up to the plate once these situations arise. Because really, it's too much for one person to handle multiple roles. And to that point, I really do have to agree with Ms. Anne. So just a few more comments. Thank you also for our participants who have been helping us clarify some of the questions. For example, Nev actually answered a question before it was asked. So good stuff. Thank you very much. Of course, it allows us to cut down the time. Another question, what happens if by chance they have more or less same speech?
Okay, as said, okay, the judges must notify the chief judge or the contestant, and then the judges will have to deliberate on it. Okay, that's when the judge when they can determine if the contestant is disqualified or not.
Yeah, and I think also our second speaker addressed that. Maybe subject for protest, but not automatic disqual. And can the judges disregard the results in 2016? So this was a reference of previous incident probably, it took them 1 hour to deliberate on their judgment.
Well, it happened in the past. That's why we are conducting this session. We know how to address such concerns. Yeah. Okay? We know how to address concerns.
Yeah. So really, I really do believe that Ms. Anne sufficiently answered all our questions. And probably if you still have questions, you can just continue by sending her a private message, of course, through our Zoom chat box so that we can proceed to our next speaker who is actually being active right now as we close our first Q&A session. Of course, just to give a brief rundown of what will happen next before I continue on, of course, we'll be having our second speaker and then we'll have another round of Q&A before we actually go to our breakout session. So that's one thing that we have to look forward to. We will actually need to apply all of these things that we've been learning so far. But of course, I would not disallow anybody to, you know, go out of the cameras for a bit, grab a drink or some snacks, and then just come back so that we can proceed with our session affairs. So, are you ready for the second speaker? So just do a virtual thumbs up, or you can use your own physical thumb for that. One thumb, two thumbs, it's okay. But then again, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The audience has been so far very well-mannered. You know, we're not hearing any intermittent sounds, people not forgetting to mute their mics. So all of you have been great so far. I'd like to just point that out. Thank you very much for being a kind audience to all of us. So we proceed to the second speaker. Ha, this one's really interesting. Why? Let me proceed. She grew up in the family of Toastmasters. Wow. Her mom brought her along to club meetings when she was younger. Then her sister asked her to facilitate a speechcraft program in her school, which eventually led her to the Toastmasters programs. She was a division governor in 2009-2010. She had formed and chartered many clubs, both in District 75 and in the U.S., and continues to form clubs even to this day. She is also a builder of learners, an inspiration to many. She was the district governor from 2013 to 2014. She brought District 75 to Residence Distinguished District, a feat that is really something to cherish. She served as district trainer for the past 3 years, and currently she is the district consultant. She is referred to as the Google of District 75. She is an epitome of servant leader. So it is my distinct honor to introduce, to welcome. So please do join me in welcoming our second speaker this morning, District Governor Katrina J.J. Letargo, our distinguished Toastmaster.
Hello, yes. Good morning, everyone. So in the interest of time, so we can all practice judging later, I will make my talk as short as possible. So now we will look at the role of the judges. Is my screen the one being shared? Okay. So the objectives of this particular topic is to know the purpose of the judge, the characteristics of a good judge, be familiar with the judging forms and ballots, and of course, we will practice the role. So in the chat box, I would like to know who among the participants here has never been a contest judge ever, and that this is your first. Can I see? Babalik ta rin ko. I need a thumbs up sign if you have never been asked to judge any speech contest. So I think most of you have been asked to take on the role of a judge. We have one. We have Arlene. Never been asked to judge. We have another one, Jaw. Okay. So we have Regine. It is actually challenging to take on the role of the judge because as a judge, whether you are a voting judge or a chief judge, it takes a lot of decision making and judgment calls on your part. So for the tech team, I hope you can also share in the chat box the copy of the forms, judges eligibility form, and the contest ballots that we will use later. So have you ever felt that, you know, judges selected the wrong winner in a speech contest because you have your own favorite or you think that this other person should be the winner? So it happens. So as a judge, you have to make sure that you select the speaker who has given the best speech for that particular category. Because there are instances that you have contestants that they are the same contestant in the table topics, also in the international speech category. And then you tend to compare, oh, I think this speaker was better when the speaker was delivering the speech in table topics and so on. So you have to select the person or the speaker for that category. So as chief judge, here are the things that you have to consider before the contest. You need to appoint and counsel your voting judges, your counters, your timers, and even the secret tie-breaking judge. It's only the chief judge who knows who your tie-breaking judge is. You're also the one who needs to make sure that you have the judge's certification. Okay. And even they have to sign this one. You have to make sure that you believe them. What's been happening now is that there is a contest briefing that happens prior to the speech contest. And that's not happening only during or a few minutes before the speech contest. And as chief judge, you also act as chief counter and check on the counter's tally sheet. Okay. After the contest, what happened to my screen? There you go. You have to also collect from the timer the record sheet. And then you have to also take a look at the tie-breaking judges ballot, resolve any eligibility or protest, which happens. There was one in a previous area contest, I think. And you need to oversee the counting process to see that all ballots are counted. And you provide a list to the contest chair to show the placement of all contestants. All contestants, not just the top three. Why is it important? Because come next level of competition, so let's say you were a chief judge at the area level. You need to know the names of all the rank from the first contestant to the last contestant so that if anything happens at the next level, the division contest, then if in case the winner or the first place winner can't make it, you go to the second place winner. If again, the second place winner can't make it, the third place winner will represent that area in the division level competition. That has happened before at the district level. So the division champion can't make it. So the second place winner was supposed to fly to Cebu. But then again, there was an emergency. So that person wasn't able to fly. Good thing that the third place winner was already in Cebu. Though that person did not practice, but that person was tasked to represent the division in that particular competition. So you need to know who the winners are from first place to the last place, as long as they are not disqualified due to time or any protest. Okay? So here are the appointed functionaries. So make sure that if you are holding any contest at the club level, here are the number of functionaries that you are available. So if you notice at the club and area, it says you're a minimum of 5 voting judges. Don't limit yourself to 5 voting judges, especially now that we are doing contests online. And if there are internet connectivity issues, the more, the merrier. So the more voting judges you will have, it's easier for you. And if you notice, based on the question earlier, some responded you only needed 2 counters, some 3. The question earlier was at the district speech contest. So if it is a district speech contest, you need 3 tally counters or ballot counters. But if it's just a club, area, or division, you may just have 2 counters available. So take note that at the area contest, there must be an equal number of voting judges. And then at the division contest as well, and even at the district contest. And take note that the judge must not be a member of any club in which a contestant is a member when we talk of the division and district contest. That's why a lot of times we just invite judges coming from other divisions and sometimes even district. So make sure that every club, every area, every division is represented based on the level of contest that you will be having. All right. If you are a voting judge, you need to select the first, second, and third place winner. This is a sample of the ballot for the judge. So you need to fill it out, you tally the points, and make sure that if there's a tie, you break your own tie, and you have to even rank your contestant first, second, and third place winner. So don't forget to please write your name, sign, and of course write your top 3 winners. The PDF, the file sent by TI, is actually editable, and you can even put a digital signature. So the sample entry earlier, you've seen this. So you have to put your first place, second place, and third place winner. Now, if you are the tie-breaking judge, that's why it was not discussed earlier, because it is only known to the chief judge. As tie-breaking judge, it is your duty to rank all speakers. So if you notice, you still have to tally your or put a score for each speaker. But instead of just placing your first, second, and third place winner, you have to write all winners. Okay? From if there are 10 contestants, then you have to write all 10 contestants' names. Okay? Same thing, you have to write your name, sign, and rank the names of the contestants. Okay. So as chief judge, it is again your duty to make sure that the ballot is valid. How can it not be valid? There was one contest that happened recently where in the, normally some areas have joint contests. Okay. And of course, there was a particular instance where in the names written in the judge's ballot were the names of the contestant for that area. So let's say area 1 and 2 had a joint contest. So as the judge writing the names, it's not for the winners for, and usually let's say area one had the contest first. So you have to write your, you know, top three. But then again, the names were for the area two competition. So automatically, these are the wrong contestants for the wrong contest. So it's not going to be valid. So take note of that one. So what happens when there's a tie, then the chief judge will have to open the tie-breaking ballot and compare the ranking. And for some, okay, to help the tallyer for the ranking, they put a symbol at the name of the person or of the score so as to know the difference and to illustrate. Some use one, some use 0.5, but when you use a number, a lot of times the tally or the ballot counters become confused because they add up the score. So to show you a sample, recall earlier, so granting, how many ties do we have right here? Looking at the scores, this is from the tally sheet of the counter. So we still have one, two, this Dimitri, Porsche, and the Luna. Okay. Who should be the first place winner? Can you write it on the chat box? Okay. Let me see. All right. So there's a tie over there. You need to take a look at now who would be the second place winner because Dimitri is the first place winner. Okay. So the next who got a tied score, it's Juan and Portia. Who should be the next? Who should be the second place winner? Okay. So to help the counter, you may want to put a plus sign because based on the tie-breaking judge's ballot, based on the ranking of the names, Juan came first before Portia. Okay, so your third place winner now becomes Portia. All right. Okay. Sometimes what I've noticed, some of the counters, they put a point. They say they will add 3 points to Deluna, they will add 2 points to Juan, and then they will put 1 point to Portia. That's not the case. You don't add points anymore based on the tie-breaking judge's ballot. So don't get confused. So automatically, Deluna becomes the fourth place winner and Tudis the fifth place winner. Okay, so don't get confused. Don't add scores when you look at the tie-breaking judges ballot. It's really just ranking. Right. So for the judging criteria, if you notice, for Table Topics Humor International, they have the same categories, content, delivery, and language. But for evaluation, they have a different set of judging criteria. You have to judge based on analytical quality, recommendations, technique, and submission. And even the categories are very much different. So I do recommend that if you will be asked to judge a speech contest, let's say it's face-to-face or you get the forms, please read the second page, not just the first page, because on the second page of the form, it shows you the description for each judging criteria. Okay. Prior to the pandemic, when we were doing face-to-face, and usually they print, you know, the judge's form, but it's just the first page. So when you're asked to judge, you just look at the first page. So if we're going to do that again after the pandemic, please print the two pages so that your judges will have an opportunity to reorient themselves on the description on the judging criteria. Some reminders, because we're doing online speech contests, have a backup for all roles, including the test speaker. I attended one contest and suddenly the test speaker had internet connectivity problems. So how can you have an evaluation speech contest without the test speaker? For the chief judge, make sure that all judges will be able to view and watch all speech contestants. So if possible, like Anne earlier, have more than one device so that you have a backup. Now, this happened in one contest that I was the chief judge. One contestant in the middle of the speech gets disconnected. but already reached the minimum required speech time. So they were asking me, is that person disqualified? I said, no, because when I checked the timer, the remember for disqualification in terms of speaking time, that speaker is still qualified because I think it's an evaluation speech contest. The speaker was able to reach the 2-minute mark, which is the minimum requirement. So in essence, the person is not disqualified. So the judges must still put a score for that contestant based on that 2-minute presentation. So again, if there is a protest, majority of the voting judges must concur. So as a judge, it's really a judgment call on your part. It has happened to me lots of times in different categories. And you have to be very much aware of the contents of the speech contest rule book because you cannot just make a judgment call without looking again what the Toastmasters International Speech Contest rule book says. But there are a lot of gray areas, actually. So, qualities of a good judge, you have to be fair and impartial. Even if the contestant is a friend of yours, you have to stick with the objectives or the judging criteria. You have to be objective. You have to be accurate, especially when you're a voting judge and you have to write, you know, you have to compute. So don't make it difficult for you. Just use whole numbers. Don't put, let's say, I want to give the score of 10.5 or 10.34. So it's going to be difficult for you to compute for that one. You have to be trustworthy. All scores that you put and even your ballot should be confidential. Don't show it to anyone. Don't compare notes. Don't ask people who did you choose as your first, second, and third winner. Even timers and the ballot counters, do not discuss. Oh, you know, this judge put this person in the last rank. Okay? So don't discuss that. You have to be knowledgeable, especially with the speech contest rulebook. You have to be a good listener. So for contest chairs and handling contests, please don't make it difficult for your judges. Normally, you have the 4 categories in one day, and you have the same number of judges. And you have, let's say, 8 contestants or 10 contestants per category. Can you imagine a judge listening to 40 contestants the whole day? So as much as possible, you have to switch judges. If you can have different judges for all 4 categories, then well and good. But if you can't, at least just give them roles for 2 categories. It's really difficult to judge a contest and you've been the judge for all categories on the same day. As a judge, remember your purpose. You have to select the speaker who has given the best speech. Not a simple one. It's a question about table topic scoring. Okay, we'll go to that later, Victor. Again, the resources that you would be able to use. If there's a need for you to take on any tutorial, it's also available at the Toastmasters International site. Okay. Victor, I'll take on that question. Go ahead. Can you clarify about the table topic story?
Yeah. Just recently, I've been going to a lot of Toastmasters clubs meetings.
Okay, what's that?
I've been going to some Toastmasters clubs and I've heard this expression whenever there's table topics. They say, it's okay, you have up to 30 seconds to think. And I go, what? This is supposed to be an impromptu speech. So you can imagine that you're being interviewed on TV, on camera, and somebody asks you a question. You don't take 30 seconds on TV to respond, right? Maybe 1 or 2 seconds, and then you have to say something. So as a judge in table topics, I usually would like to take 1 or 2 points off, or how many points, if somebody takes too long to respond. So my question is that okay? Because I just don't get this 30-second rule. I don't know where it came from.
Yeah, it's really your judgment call as a judge, if you want to take off points. Again, the person will not be disqualified. if they take too long in front, because the timer starts when the person says and the first word or any action. So it's really, people will just be staring at the person. So it's a, no, case to case, but definitely if you're a judge and you want to deduct points, if you want to, then deduct points. If it's in the technique or it's in one of the criteria.
I just don't understand where this 30 seconds came from when that started.
Well, maybe a mentor has offered that suggestion to one of the mentees, and the mentee has been doing that. So, because normally it takes really about 5 to 10 seconds when you stand in front, and then you really have to deliver your material or your speech for table topics. Not 30 seconds. It's not cast in stone, really.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Any other question before we, can you share the gray areas you mentioned earlier? Okay. Gray area we're in, just like the, if you look at the speech contest rule book, for example, and this was in relation to the question earlier, Victor, I saw it. If it's, what's that? If a, the second contestant refers to a speech, no matter how small it is, from the previous speech, will the speaker be disqualified? So that's why it's not automatic disqualification. Now, in terms of reference, there's not really a clear-cut statement wherein if the speaker will verbatimly mention, let's say, 10 words from the previous speaker, it's not written there. It just said reference. So what do we mean by reference? Is it like, there was a contest that had a protest. Can I ask Jazz to, no? No doubt, no. Okay, so there was a contest wherein, let's say, there was a, not a quotation, let's say a line in a statement or a poem or a song, okay, which was also used by the previous contestant. So will that be subject for disqualification? It may be a subject for protest, but it didn't really say if it's a whole line or it's a whole set, paraphrasing the whole quotation. That's a gray area because it's not cast in stone when we talk of reference. How long, how short, what if it's just the name? So that's a gray area. Did I answer the question? What's the name?
Yes, thanks.
Okay, so Redentor. Okay, Redentor, did I answer your question? That's one gray area. There are other gray areas, actually, if you read through the contest rule book. So it's really about a judgment call. Any other question? Okay, how long judgment after disqualification is treated? As soon as possible. You have to decide as soon as possible. Case in point, I was chief judge for a table topic speech contest at a district level competition. It just so happened that after the first speaker, we noticed that the question was being heard in the hallway of the building. So the other contestants who were supposed to be in the holding area already heard the question. Okay. So as chief judge, I had to tell the contest master, contest chair to stop the contest. I had to convene with the judges to agree to repeat the contest. And so, the second contestant was already in front waiting for the, you know, there's that 1 minute of silence. So we had to call again all the other contestants. Okay. So that's why it's a judgment. So as how long judge? Yeah. So the judgment should be as quick as possible. Now, there's a protest about originality. So the process now, somebody lodges a protest, tells the chief judge. Chief judge will inform the other judges. Chief judge calls the contestant who's being protested, the protester and the protested. Okay? And then let the person explain. Okay. And then talks again, convinced with the other judges. And good thing, sometimes lucky for a chief judge, because you sometimes you of course you have to tell the person that okay, you will be disqualified based on this, this, and this. It's good if the contestant is also parang had time disqualification, because it lessens the blow of being disqualified due to the other items mentioned. It has happened also before. So there were three contestants, I think, humor speech contest. One contestant forgot the speech but was still within time. The other contestant just made a lot of song rendition. And then the third contestant, I forgot what happened to the third contestant. So the judges had a hard time deciding because they think that based on the criteria, nobody qualified for that speech contest. And so they were saying, how can we qualify these contestants? Okay. But we said that as voting judges, you need still to put, need to put a point or score each contestant. Good thing that the other one who just, you know, based on just saying a lot of song rendition also got overtime. So the one who forgot the speech but still within time won that contest. So judgment call. It's always a judgment call. What's this? That are streamed on Facebook. How do we discourage possible cheating? Okay, so as much as possible for table topics, it's not really streamed on Facebook when the contest is happening. They usually have the contest wherein you only have the functionaries, so the judges, the role takers, who are in the Zoom meeting space. After that, then they now have the announcement after or show it after. Of course, for all functionaries, you have to make sure, again, you have to be trustworthy. You cannot leak the results. You cannot, you know, post that congratulations because everybody else didn't know what the results are yet. It's also, will it also be safe to mention an internal contest rule to any club? Okay, Melinda, I need to check this one. In relation to TM Victor's question, safe to mention as an internal contest rule of any club. What do you mean internal contest rule? We always follow the Toastmasters International speech contest rule book. Okay. That's just the book that we will follow. And the gray area also there is unless practicable ba yung nakalagay dun. That's the gray area also in the speech contest rule book. Unless practicable, I think. Can someone check that particular word that they always use? Just curious from Alan. Online contest. Yes, there had been protests. There was one recently. A protest was raised based on originality because the contestant wasn't aware of that new item in the rule book that you cannot anymore reference the speech of a previous contestant. So yes, there was a protest launch. Okay, so let's practice. We can... Can I park the other questions? I will answer them, you know, while the contestants, while all of the participants are trying or will do the, or practice being a judge for today. So before we proceed to that, just a reminder, be humble, be teachable, and always keep learning. There's always something new. And there are, you know, fine print in the speech contest rule book that we always have to watch out. So just keep the questions coming. I will answer them in the chat box. Okay. So speech contest workshop, are you ready?